Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and if you're new around here, welcome. My name is Elise, and I would love for you to hit that subscribe button and join my little YouTube family. So today I'm going to show you guys how I achieved these retro Hollywood style pin-up-y curls. I figured I haven't done a hair tutorial in what seems like forever, so I wanted to bring it back today, and not to mention I did recently give myself a pretty substantial trim. I did cut my hair shorter, so I figured what better time to do a hair tutorial than right now. Absolutely love how this look turned out, and if you know how to use the curling iron, then you are already 10 steps ahead. I really hope you guys enjoy this video, and if you want to see how to do it, then please keep watching.
First things first, you want to go in with your favorite heat protectant. This one is mine. I will list it down below for you guys, but you never want to forget this step because you want to prevent the most heat damage you can for your hair. I'm going to go in and start splitting it up, and I'm taking this Revlon 1-inch barrel curling iron, and the way I'm going to do this is I'm going to curl the hair downward. As you can see here, I clip it and then I roll my way up. It's actually a very simple process. I don't really accustom myself to using curling irons, and I even found this really easy to do. Once I do that and I let it go, I hold it for about 5 seconds. I roll that up and then I pin it with a bobby pin. And that's pretty much it. That's what I'm gonna do for the whole head. I'm not gonna alternate the curl position in any way. As you can see, again, I'm just going to clip that, roll it down, and then bring the hair up. And then I'm gonna hold that for about 5 to 10 seconds, depending on how much hair I have in the curling iron rod, and then I'm going to let it go. I take about 1 to 1.5 inch sections of hair, then I roll that up and I bobby pin it. It's really that simple. Another thing is, if you're not good with curling irons, you can also opt out and use hot rollers if you would prefer, and you're gonna get a similar look. So once your hair is fully curled, pinned, and out of your face, girl, now it's time to have a good old time. So what I like to do is I just like to dance. I like to take some selfies. Girl, I like to admire my shoulder highlights. I just like to go all out, balls to the walls, no F's given, okay? Take about 5 to 10 minutes and just let that fully sit and let all of your hair cool down. Now what I'm going to do is just shake the hair off, just kind of run my fingers through it. I'm not going to use a brush or anything like that for this step, just because I like it when it looks a little bit more PC. I don't want it to look too brushed out. I don't want the curls to totally look like they were brushed away, you know what I mean? So I'm just going to shake it off with my fingers and kind of run my fingers through it. To get that front section of hair to look a little bit more lifted and vintage, what I do is I just kind of take some hairspray and take a comb and just lift that upwards just a couple of times, and the hairspray will kind of just lock that in place. Then I kind of just use my fingers to clamp that together. You can tease it if you would like, if your hair would fall, but my hair typically doesn't. So the next thing that I do is I'm going to take a barrette or some bobby pins like these. These are kind of like some funky looking cute little bobby pins I found at Walmart. And I'm just going to take that and put it on the left side of my face and kind of just pin that backwards for another more vintagey 50s kind of feel. And that's going to complete this look, you guys. I really hope you enjoyed it. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye.